just got out at the 7th and Hope. Or 7th and Grand. I can't remember what the name of the stop is, but I'm on 7th Street right now in downtown Los Angeles. Let's see. Walking to Bottega Louie, then I'm gonna go to King Pleasure, which is Basquiat's exhibition or exhibit, whatever. Exhibition, exhibit, I think. That's downtown. So I'll get my coffee or my macaroon and hop back on the train, and that'll be it. I'll go back a couple more stops that I need to go. Bottega Louie is one of my favorite coffee and pastry shops in California, or anywhere really. It's just beautiful. Wait till you see it. I used to live just a few blocks away. I used to just walk here almost every day. There it is on the corner there. So we're gonna make this. Whole Foods down there, but I mean, like, just look at these freaking macaroon trees and stuff. Just beautiful. Alright, I'm gonna ask if I can shoot video. Some fashionable people walking across the street. They said it was cool, so. Is it okay if I get video of your dog? Is it cool? Thank you, thank you. Man. Oh, the tasty goodness. And then you can buy the pre-box stuff. Coffee and Basquiat is just on Grand, so I figured it's 7/10 of a mile, so I figured I'll just glass down there.
We're out here in the downtown streets of LA. It's a beautiful Friday morning. You see the vibes, catch them.
What's your name?
My name's Malcolm. Malcolm Amin.
Malcolm Amin. Do you do anything? Do you do any artistic work, Malcolm?
I like modeling, like the style. That's my shit.
Cool, man. That's awesome. If I ever put this anywhere, is there any place anybody can find you?
Yeah, my Instagram is at MALC300, at Malc3000.
Cool, man. Thanks for stopping.
No problem. Good talking to you, man.
See you, man.
Have a good one.
Yeah, okay. Very good. Thank you. All right. Had to make a little pit stop back in Bottega Louie. Got stopped by our friend Malcolm. I've never met Malcolm before, but we're going to call him a friend. And so, just 0.7 miles down this way to the King of Pleasure exhibit. So I figured we'll just walk around and see what we see. First time I had that was at Disney with Sarah, and we had this, I can't remember the name of it, it was an IPA, and it was called like something like Aurora Hopialis. It was Aurora Borealis, but they made a IPA joke about it, or play on words rather. And so we are in downtown. I used to, when I was living here in 2015, 2016, and to be, 2017, well, more 2015, 2016, when I lived down here, I would walk around this general area, probably like like 6 square blocks. And that's where I would take most of my photos. And then I would explore all the time. Oh, crap. I would explore all the time just to see all the different places, like the last bookstore and just the different restaurants and shops and just all kinds of stuff. And I don't know how well this microphone can pick up, but this is just doing what it is. So this camera was made in, 2000-ish. 2003, maybe. So it's kind of cool. Dang, dual buses. Got the super long, stretchy, bendy bus. Oh man. I'm cheating on Starbucks. It's down there. I'm gonna walk right past it with my Bottega Louie iced coffee. Hopefully, no alarms get triggered. Oh man. I do not want to be walking up that hill. We're gonna have to do it. We're gonna have to do it. I remember when I first lived. Oh, let's walk down Pershing Square. It's just a block off. And I'll show you the building where I used to live. And then, maybe we can walk through the Biltmore. Alright, this will be alright. Be all right. Ike's love and sandwiches. Yeah, buddy. So right here, the camera's down. I'm holding my arm all the way down. I'm holding the camera from the top. And it's mid-thigh, closer to my knee, but mid-thigh, three-quarter thigh. I can't really keep an eye on it as well. And when you see Pershing Square, you'll see why I wanted to go by here instead of just walking by, a bunch of buildings, which is what I would have been doing. There we go. Pershing Square. Alright, and you see that building with Kobe on it? There we go, let's see if we can zoom in. That's where I lived. It's right when you hop out of the train station, that's the first building you see. And I lived, I think, on the 7th floor, and there's a rooftop pool and all that stuff, and it was cool. I spent my birthday 2015 up there just kicking it, and it was awesome. It was awesome. And that's one of the first birthdays that I had where I decided that I wanted to just spend it alone. I got the little hot dog cart. It's the best stuff right there. Alright, and the Biltmore Hotel is right there. Pershing Square. That's where I just came from. I had to show you the hot dog stand. And then Perch is in that building. I'll point with the straw. But this is Pershing Square. OG, yeah, real. 25 years old, man. Thing about walking around here with this is people recognize the type of camera, everything like that guy just did. Which is really cool. All these like city bikes, that's cool. Metro bike. Sorry. City bike, I guess, is a brand name. I think it's like City Credit Cards, Citibank, and I think that's more in New York. And then they had the largest lightsaber fight. So I looked from the roof, I saw them all 2015. Around Christmas time, having the lightsaber fight. And I have video of that somewhere. They have this tree, so this is Pershing Square. And, oh, they still got the ice skating rink, yeah. But they had just like hundreds, if not a couple thousand, Star Wars fans, because that's when the new. I can never remember the names. The one with Daisy Ridley, her first one. So that movie had just was coming out, so they were doing a lot of promotion, so they had a big Star Wars. And there's the U.S. Bank building. Am I getting it? There's the top right there. I can probably zoom in closer. Boom. Nuggets, so we're gonna put this on where I live. Oh, this is actually really nice, holding the camera like this. I'm holding it from the back with my hand like cradling underneath it and my thumb kind of like supporting it by where the strap is. It's really cool. I mean, look at these freaking buildings. the thing about Los Angeles compared to like New York. Dang, look at all those birds up there. What is going on? See those? Is that focusing? There was a freaking hot dog on the ground yesterday. I think I was shooting video when that happened. There was a hot dog on the freaking ground, and all the seagulls were swarming on Hollywood Boulevard. I was like, dang, I don't want one to poop on me, because that's happened a couple of times. And the thing about bird poop or seagull poop, who knew this is what we were going to be talking about today? The thing about it is when that happens, it's so light, and you just don't feel it, especially if it's on like a sweater or a coat or something. And then you find it later. Happened once when I was, the two times I remember, that's Hotel Biltmore to the left. Two times I remember it happening was once in the parking lot of high school, and the other time was in London. I think it might have happened to Sarah as well. And that was, man, that was, I was real fussy that day. So I've calmed down quite a bit since then through a lot of help. And I mentioned in, you know, wherever this ends up, in some of my collectible videos and even some of my, on my old YouTube channel, I mentioned, you know, some negative things happening in my life that I've had to heal from. And I thought I healed from it when I was younger, when I was in my 20s, when I first started going to therapy, and that was just scratching the surface of what actually was going on. There we go, we got the walk sign. Let's give the walk sign man a freaking, where are you, buddy? There we go. Coffee this way, fantastic. So when I was shooting, there's the building again. It's my old apartment building. Ooh, nails and waxing. I always need to get my nails waxed. And this is it, Biltmore Hotel. This is where the first few Academy Awards were hosted. Maybe the first like 10 years. Let's see if I can. Tea room. It's absolutely beautiful. We're just gonna walk right through. This has been in plenty of movies. There's a little water fountain there. I think so. This was in Oppenheimer, like this area. A lot of times they use this for scenes that are outside of the country or at like nice big restaurants or something. And then shoot weddings here in the bride and groom. It's just a beautiful place. I might get stopped here. Let's see. How you doing? Beautiful hallway. And then this is where the Ghostbusters scene was shot. It was in here where they caught Slimer. Let's see if we can't get. So this is like the lobby, and this is where you can match the roof tiles and the light and everything in that front area and all the fixtures and the walls to the movie. So it's really freaking cool. But we won't stay in here too long. It's just very nice, just beautiful place to visit. Love coming down here. Wish you know where I am. There's that. Let's see. What do we? All right, we're gonna exit this street. I think this is 6th Street. Like, look at the ceiling. Freaking beautiful that is. And then I'm gonna go to the side of the chandelier just to show you some more of the beautiful ceiling. Like, it's just absolutely beautiful. Exit. Do the long shot of the hallway. See how big it is. It's beautiful.
emerald room.
Oh, let me show you the... I'll go back. I'm going to show you the big picture they have set up in the hallway of the... what's it called? The Academy Awards at the first year. All right, I'll start it again. All right, there it is right there. Let's see. It's just such old school Hollywood stuff. So they used to host the Academy Awards here first few years, and these are all ballrooms that are marked by these signs. That, like, that sign right there, there's one down there, there's one there, there's one there. And then there's some, you know, down, there's the lobby one and all over there. And they're just like big ballrooms where they host big events, which is just really cool. Very, very, very Hollywood, early Hollywood. There's the big room again. Very early Hollywood. It's just wonderful to just kind of see this stuff. All right, we walked out, and there's red carpet right there. And this is Fifth Street. Thought it was Sixth. Biltmore, Los Angeles. And when I was shooting, second shooting for Cameron, shot a wedding down here, and it was just beautiful, just beautiful. And then there, to put it in perspective, that building right there, that's the apartment. So it was just wonderful to be able to just walk out the door and see all these really cool historic buildings. Just be near it, you know, like, it's just wonderful. Pershing Square again. And then... Alright. Yes. Wrong way. One-way streets. That's one thing about downtown here, is there's so many one-way streets that are... It can get confusing, because when I was down here too, I wasn't able to just support myself on the photography and video stuff. I drove Uber for a little while, and that was a whole thing. And so I got to learn the area a lot better, which I recommend if you have the means, and like, meaning that you have a car already that can qualify, and you move to a new area, go ahead and sign up for Uber or Lyft. Because you learn the area a lot quicker doing it that way. And, yeah. So, dang, gotta walk up this slow death of a hill. It's not bad, it's just... As I've gotten more out of shape and, I mean, I've been moving a lot more and I've lost a considerable amount of weight. I'm still have a lot to lose in my age, so I'm just always noticing challenges with physical activity, more so than I would when I was younger. There I am. All right, we'll start again once we get up this hill. The hill. But I figured this had to show this building at least a little bit. And somewhere around here, when I was taking some engagement photos, they explained to me, Scott and Andrea, they explained to me about how there's a, like, a one-third size version of the Renaissance Center that was built in Detroit that they built here. Hungry Howies, no way. Love Hungry Howies. Don't think about it. All right. So we got the Broad over there. Look at the line. You got Warhols in there. You got Basquiat's. You got all kinds of incredible stuff. Herrings, and that's the Disney Music Hall. You see a ton of pictures taken like in that crevice, right, which is a walkway if you get up those stairs right there and go, you can actually walk through that little area. So
this is it.
We'll go in there in just a second.
It's okay, I just want to show all this stuff.
There's the man.
So we had to walk around, go to the courtyard.
It's in like a courtyard just around the corner, which is freaking sweet. Here's the entrance.
Hello,
thank you. Thank you so much.
Hey. For the sickles, for the mattocks, for the forks, for the axes. And the earth was formless, void, darkness upon the face of the deep, the spirit moved across the water, and was light. It was good.
Thank you.
this is Janine. And this is Lusanne. Welcome to the Jean-Michel Basquiat King Pleasure Exhibition.
Step forward for an intimate glimpse into the life and journey of Jean-Michel Basquiat.
So my dad comes home one day and says, we are moving to Puerto Rico for a couple of years. There's beaches, we can swim every day.
We went and we did. Every single day.
And it was a beautiful time.
Yeah.
But there were a few things that were not so great. It was just kind of subtle things that occurred that you just kind of experience as a Black person.
As we're moving out, you know, there was some name calling and that kind of thing, and I know Jean-Michel was really frustrated and upset by that. So it was almost like the energy that they had and the thoughts they had all along came out as we were leaving. And I think it helped to shape his, some of his perspectives about race and that kind of thing. When I was 5 or 6, my family had gone up to Austin to visit. So we're in the back plane, and
seen all the textures and everything. So stretchers, the makeshift stretchers. Almost looks like a door, but it's not, which is cool. You can see all the chunkiness of the oil stick. He just went for it. To the molding, so it's like molding that you use on the floor. The stretchers, that's just awesome. I just freaking nailed it. Something I loved as a child about going to museums, and even more so as an adult, seeing all the textures. Sometimes when like works of the masters are like up on the wall and so far away, it's hard to tell, to see the paint stroke, the brush strokes. That always created a distance for me. And being able to get closer. Big this one is, you can't. I'm not gonna be able to get this one in. Being able to get closer, I really love that. I'm taking a picture. So. freaking huge. I always wanted to see the ones where, with the makeshift stretchers, and there they are. Freaking sweet. And then sometimes, they paint all black, like a matte finish, and then it looks like a chalkboard to me, which I really enjoy. So many are untitled. Hinged door, yeah. So not necessarily a French door, but a hinged door, which is cool. Let's go around to the other side. Freaking awesome. Almost full to the end of this.
It's all very crude, and I love it. I love the blue. I'm going the opposite way of the flow. Evenly cut. It's freaking awesome. This is when his the graffiti artist got killed, I believe. By the police. I think in the subway, which was just frickin' it's a good shot of the decal. What's that?
DV9 camera,
DV8? Mini DV. Is that what you're asking? Yeah, like what kind of tapes? Yeah, it's mini DV. I think it's like GL... No. GL1? Something like that. That's... This one's really intense. This is going to be the end of the first exhibit. Well, you can't miss it. It's label number 2 right there.
Thank you, sir.
It's just a raw freaking canvas,
isn't it?
That's not raw. Let's see if the painted owner. Man, it's so heavy. Yeah, like a pine like base coat or something.
What about gesso?
Where's that gesso? The color difference. I don't
That was freaking incredible. And you just get to walk out to the Disney concert hall, or orchestra hall, Disney concert hall, and the road. Freaking awesome. Thank you, Jean-Michel. I got two postcards, and I'm very happy, so this was wonderful. Just look at the sun. It's even more spectacular with these old cameras. Just looks so freaking cool. Everybody's lined up at the road. Freaking wild. That is just so beautiful. It's freaking awesome. What a wonderful experience. It's got the little concave thing in there. I don't remember who designed this building, but it was... it's magnificent. It's absolutely magnificent. So is the Disney. A couple of food trucks. Common Los Angeles thing. That's it. What a wonderful, wonderful time. Oh, we're going to walk over a bridge. So this is going to be nice. The more I walk towards these buildings, the more the sun just gets incredible on them, so I gotta get it. And there's, the buildings aren't as tall here as they are in like New York. I mean, these are pretty tall buildings, just not one after the other like in New York. So the Chipotle, little local Mexican spot. Omni. I think I took pictures of somebody with their violin. Can't remember who it was. Down in this little spot right here. I had like a Groupon to try to promote. Ooh, that's dangerous. Good thing they have that cone there. it was like $50 or $100 to do some photos and anyway, I took pictures of them. Heritage Kitchen. Oh, damn, that stuff looks so good. I don't know why I'm so obsessed with these buildings right now. It's just the sun, I guess, coming off of them. Let's see what's over here, shall we? What do we got? Is this a ramp? Yeah, it is. Go, baby, go. Ooh. Interesting. A little square, little concert hall type area. I don't know what that is. US Bank building again. We're getting right up there, guys. Look at that zoom. Unprecedented.
Dang. Crazy zoom. There it is. There is the mini Renaissance Center. Unbelievable. So I guess the same architect and materials and everything were used for this building. And that was according to Scott, who, I don't know if he's a city planner or what, but in Detroit. And yeah, so anyway, it's like a third or half the size of the Renaissance Center in Detroit. Looks pretty much identical. It has the larger cylinder in the center and then the three surrounding cylinders, just like the Renaissance Center, which was GM headquarters. And I'm not sure if it's GM headquarters anymore, and it could be. So this is really cool. Really, really cool walking around Los Angeles, downtown Los Angeles. Capturing this on analog technology. Ooh boy, don't get caught up in the barbed wire. Friggin' awesome. Ooh. Big sculpture. Cool. I think this is the Biltmore right here. I think, oh, the library. I think that's Yes, sir. Pretty sure that's the library. That I'll be able to actually film in there. But we will see. We're at the base of the US Bank building. Alright, go, go, get it, zoom. Wait, yeah, that's Bank of America, yeah. Security said it was okay. Beautiful art. escalators. Go. Sweet. So this is the children's library. I'll just show the top. Cool. Alright, let's go back down. I think the children's library were the ones that when I was recommended to come here, that's what I was recommended to go take a look at, so you gotta get to see those at least. That was just a brief tour of the Los Angeles Library, public library. Let's get the different perspective.
Thank you.